Welcome to All Things Mac, I'm your host Jim Fair. Today, another video about the new iMac. I deleted the first two. Why? I was a little slow getting to the point, and I watched a funny video over on camera conspiracies that made me embarrassed about those two videos. Okay, so here's the point. Do not buy the new iMac off the shelf, okay? Why? All of the off-the-shelf models are slowed down, crippled by the fact there's a hard drive inside. Now, just because they call it a fusion drive doesn't mean it's not a hard drive. It is. It's a big hard drive with a small solid-state drive. Or on the 21-inch, the low-end model, it's a hard drive. And it's not even a 7200 RPM hard drive, it's a 5400 RPM hard drive. So why are we selling this in the year 2019? I have no idea. But the only way to get a good version of this machine is custom order online. They ship it to you. That's it. That's all. There's no other way. Unless a dealer does the custom order on your behalf, which I'll grant you it's possible, but unlikely. So if you go into an Apple store and find this machine, you're stuck with a Fusion drive. Even on the most high-end version, and you're stuck with the i5 processor, not the i7 where Apple did all of its benchmark testing, right? So, you know, people are saying, oh, this is a really fast machine. Yeah, only if you customize it, they build it to your specs, and they ship it to you. And the other big problem with it is the screen is glued on. So that means it's very difficult to upgrade or service, because you have to cut the display off. You have to go around it with a knife and cut the adhesive, and you run a very big risk of breaking that display when you do that, and then it's like $1,000 repair. Our least reliable lab right now is an iMac lab with Fusion drives. Okay, so Fusion drives, I do not like them for reliability. Why? They're two devices in one, a hard drive and a solid state drive, acting as one device. But what I find it does is it doubles your chance of storage failure, because now you have two devices that can go wrong, not just one. And of course, solid state, there's no moving parts, right? So if you go pure solid state, you're much, much better off. In fact, Apple did this across its whole laptop line in 2015. And here we are, 4 years later, and they're going back to hard drives. Very sad. Anyway, don't buy the off-the-shelf model. And if you can get over the fact that the display is glued on, all power to you. And watch a little further here, and we'll show you the upgrades that I would recommend. You know, once upon a time, you could trust Apple to put together a decent machine. You didn't have to worry about any of the specs except how much storage do I get. On the laptop side, that's still the case. Sometimes you'll get an i5 processor, sometimes it'll be an i7. If you really want to push the envelope, you can customize to the new i9. But be prepared to open your pocketbook when that happens. So it's a bit odd to see Apple dabbling in the low end of the market when Steve Jobs famously said, we will not sell a garbage computer. Anyway, I think they're treading in that territory with this new iMac. And it's just shocking to me to see all the off-the-shelf models, what we call the M part numbers. Every single one of them is either hard drive or fusion drive, i5 processor or i3. There are no i7s at all in the off-the-shelf models. None. Zero. So if you want a good machine, you have to customize it. Okay, so let's take a look at a couple of these options online. I'm just going to move the camera so you can do sort of an over-the-shoulder thing and have a look, okay? So first thing, we're going to go apple.ca, and you can see that it will redirect you to apple.com/ca for Canadian pricing. And if you wanted education pricing, you would scroll all the way down to the bottom and select Shop for University. Let's show you that again. Scroll to the bottom and zoom in. Click Shop for University, and we're going to have education pricing. Okay, so we are now on the Apple for Higher Education Individuals Store homepage, right? So if we click, Mac, and then iMac New, and you can see all the tech specs and everything. But if you click Buy, which is where we need to be, you're presented with first the 21-inch displays, and then the 27-inch. So if we scroll so you can see everything here, you can see the prices range from $2,269 to $2,809. This is an i5 processor, i5, only 8 gigs of RAM, Fusion Drive, right? So no solid state anywhere to be found, no i7 anywhere to be found, unless you customize. So let's just start with the best one and look at the possibilities. So here we have processor. So we can go from an i5 to an i9 for $432 difference. And I don't know if you can see that, $432. And then we can increase the memory for 216, that's a bargain. In terms of graphics, we have a choice of the 580X or the Vega. They both have the same amount of memory, but the Vega will be faster. So if you're really into games or you do a lot of rendering in 4K, you might want to go with the more expensive card. And that brings us to storage. So look at the storage options. Again, they're trying to push you into a Fusion Drive. It's like, no, it must be solid state. So to get rid of this 2 terabyte Fusion Drive, we're going to go 512 gig solid state, or for an extra 432, we'll go a terabyte. All right, and we're going to say, okay, that looks good. Zoom out here, and we'll click Add to Bag. We're at $3,997 right now. All right, and it's going to say, oh, you know, would you like AppleCare? And it's $179 for education. We'll say, yes, we would like AppleCare. And we're going to go Review Bag. See, we're basically $4,000, right? And if we put in our postal code, so let's just put in a random postal code, M9R3A6. It's one I happen to know from Etobicoke, where I don't live anymore. So we're at $4,718.88. That's a pretty steep price for a Mac, but we are getting a bit of a powerhouse. So 3.6 gigahertz, 8th core, 9th gen Intel i9 with turbo boost up to 5 gigahertz, 16 gigs of DDR4 RAM, Radeon 580, 8 gigs of video RAM, a terabyte of solid state, the mouse, the wireless mouse, and the wireless keyboard.